This video is brought to you by VIRCI, a science and technology company offering research and development and consulting. Before we get into the video, I would like to make a few notes to the viewer. This theory might seem to go against mainstream science. In reality, these discoveries actually complement Kepler's, Newton's, and Einstein's theories of the laws of gravity in relation to the functionality of the solar system. Because their equations and theories only give the formulas with vague explanations of the forces at work, they do not address the anatomy of the gravitational force at work in the solar system. Plasma cosmology and the electric universe are two new theories that need to be incorporated into the current mainstream astronomy and cosmology theories, because new discoveries in cosmology are confirming the electromagnetic and electric nature of the universe. Climate change. Climate change and Earth changes are serious man-made issues affecting life on Earth now. However, natural cycles that can affect climate also exist. Therefore, both man-made and natural cycles are true and valid issues, and both need to be considered. The structure of the Moon and the mechanism that locks the Moon gravitationally on Earth's structure. The Moon is locked onto Earth's orbit because of the gravitational and electromagnetic attraction and repulsion between the Moon and the Earth. The Moon is split magnetically in a symmetrical manner, which creates two magnetically opposed mirror image half spheres that simultaneously pull and push, or attract and repel, gravitationally on planet Earth. This effect creates a two-way gravitational grip, locking the Moon on the planet's structure and locking it onto an orbital rotation around Earth. The Moon's half-sphere, facing toward Earth, or the near side, is pushing outward, or repelling away from the planet gravitationally and electromagnetically. And the half-sphere, on the opposite side, the far side to the Earth, is pulling or attracting towards the planet, which keeps it locked onto Earth's structure. Earth's Moon has two axes: a north-south vertical pole axis in parallel to Earth's magnetic poles, locked onto Earth's north and south polarities. A second axis, perpendicular to the first axis, pointing to Earth and locking it onto Earth's central structure, creating a two-way gravitational electromagnetic grip. Earth's Moon does not spin on its own axis, but rather it orbits Earth, which spins on its axis while orbiting the Sun. From an observational perspective of the Moon and the Sun, it would seem that the Moon is spinning on its vertical axis in relation to the Sun. It is Earth that is spinning on its own axis while in orbit around the Sun. The Moon is locked in and rotating on Earth's axis and not its own vertical axis. Due to the Moon's north-south pole axis being in parallel and locked onto Earth's northern and southern poles, and the second perpendicular axis of the Moon being locked onto the central structure of Earth, this keeps the Moon from spinning on either of its two axes. It can be observed that all symmetrically spherical satellites, aka moons, in our solar system are locked in a second perpendicular axis onto their respective orbited planet, in the same manner as Earth's Moon. This causes them to always face their planets on the same side. There are multiple possibilities that can make up the structure and composition of the inner core of a planet. The inner structure of Earth could consist of one or more inner solid core. My opinion and observation is that Earth has one solid torus inner core. After extensive research into electricity, magnetism, astrophysics and astronomy, I observed that all the planets in the solar system have unique spin and orbit periods. These periods of axial spin and revolutions around the Sun are not accidental or random, but a result of measurable interlocking conditions that keep the planets in the solar system in synchronicity and equilibrium, just like the gears in a mechanical watch. A planet's magnetosphere and axial spin force are due to one, their inner solid core and crust slash mantle material composition and structural shape; 2, their moon's size; 3, the sun's current; 4, the induction effect; and 5, and finally, the three-part homopolar generator effect. The homopolar generator effect, or three-part dynamo, is what generates a torus-shaped magnetosphere and makes a planet spin on its own axis, due to the current coming from the Sun passing through a planet's poles and into the inner solid core, in conjunction with a moon's two-way electromagnetic grip onto the shell slash mantle of the Earth. This solar current, also known as the Birkeland current, is a cord-like electromagnetic funnel that connects the Sun with each planet. It goes through the planet and possibly connects back to the Sun. The mechanism of the Sun's electromagnetic cord current passing through the poles creates a Faraday homopolar generator effect in reverse on the planet's inner solid core in conjunction with the moon's two-way gravitational grip onto the mantle and crust. This homopolar generator effect induces a spin force onto the inner core of a planet. The homopolar electromagnetic generator effect magnetizes the inner solid core. The magnetized inner core subsequently generates a torus-shaped magnetosphere over the entire planet, aligned with the Earth's magnetic poles. The magnetosphere, in turn, protects and shields the bubble-like atmosphere of the planet. This book is the first of a series of four books. This book explains the mechanism of the gravitational two-way grip between the Earth and its moon, with chapters and explanation on the Venus retrograde orbit. The second book explains the ongoing magnetic pole shift and possible mini ice age. The third book includes new theories on the dinosaur extinction, and the fourth book, not yet released, focuses more on space travel, new space propulsion technology, and the colonization of Mars. The books are available on Amazon, Apple eBooks, and Barnes & Noble in eBook and paperback format. Thank you for watching, and in the next video, we will be talking about the pole shift and the potential mini ice age.